Good afternoon, everyone. What's Agnes Adibi, and the digital communication. And people that are just joining us for the first time, Lunch and Learn is a bi-weekly in-house training session here at Futuresoft that evolved. And then it became accessible to the public. The idea behind it was to share everything we're learning with everyone that is joining us. Today, Boluwatife Oloruntola, one of our digital marketing interns, will be facilitating the session, and it's titled How to Design and Execute a Campaign. Please note, as the session goes on, you have to stay muted. And if you have any question as it goes on, please just type in the chat. We would take note of it and address it at the end of the session. Thank you for your cooperation. And I think Boluwatife, you can take it from here. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Agnes. The topic once again is how to design and execute a campaign. So before any campaign is executed, there's usually a strategy. And in that strategy, you determine who your target audience is. You determine where you are going to place your message, the social media you intend to use. And you also determine why you are doing this. That is the aim and the purpose of your campaign. You also determine how you are going to reach your target audience. And you also determine when the campaign is going to start and when it is going to finish. If you can successfully determine all this, then I believe you are going to have an effective campaign. So let's move on to what this slide entails. The outline of the slide, throughout this discussion, we'll be talking on what is a marketing campaign, types of marketing campaigns, then samples of marketing campaigns. Also, we'll be looking at the steps to designing a marketing campaign and executing successful marketing campaigns. What is marketing campaign? Marketing campaign are organized and strategized efforts to promote a specific brand goal, such as creating brand awareness, boosting sales on a particular product or services, or increasing website traffic. In this place, we are saying that if you as a brand, you intend to go on and back on marketing campaign for your product, you have to have an aim. And the aim can be to create awareness about your product or to boost sales on the product you sell or the services you render, so that your target audience can get to know more about it, or you intend to increase the website traffic on the traffic on your website. Also, marketing campaigns aim at reaching consumers in different ways, either through email, print advertising, that is the newspapers. Then you can also use your television or the radio. It depends on where your target audiences are. How do you intend to meet them? If your target audiences are on the they mostly make use of television or radio, then you can use that method to reach them. And also social media, that if your those social media platforms I'm talking about are the ones we know, once we are aware about, which is the Facebook, Twitter, or the Instagram. So if your target audience are on Facebook, Instagram, or Snapchat, then you can use that medium to reach them. Also, you have to have a specific time frame assigned to your campaign in order to be able to analyze, optimize, and test it. Why? For every campaign you are going to do as for your brand, you should have when the campaign is going to start and when it is going to finish, because you need to test it. You need to analyze that. Okay, is this campaign, how far have we gone? We said we are going to do this campaign for 1 month. So within that 1 month, we said this goal is, we said we are going to increase website traffic on our website. Okay, within this 1 month that we said that this campaign is going to be, how far have we been able to increase the traffic on the website? Are things going well? There is the need for you to test, analyze, and optimize so that you'll be able to avoid making a mistake that you've made in doing this campaign for your next campaign. So let's move on to types of marketing campaigns. So this is an overview of the various types of marketing campaigns. The first one we'll be looking at is the brand awareness campaign, the social media campaigns, the email marketing campaigns, sales promotion campaigns, advertising campaigns, and product launch campaigns. So First, the brand awareness campaign. Brand awareness campaigns have a single goal, which is to create awareness about the brand. Take for instance, you have a brand and you want to create awareness about it. You can decide to embark on a brand awareness campaign, or you have a product that you as a brand you own, but people don't know about this. You can also decide to create awareness about it. So the single aim of brand awareness, as the name implies, is just to create awareness about your brand. Also, the campaign should go beyond your brand or your logo being recognized. In a situation whereby you create this brand awareness, so at the end of the day, when I see this brand, it should not be that I'm only recognizing the logo I'm only aware about the brand name or the logo of the brand. No, let me know what the product does. Okay, you created an awareness about this, your dish liquid wash. Then let me know that this dish liquid wash, when I use it, it's going to, it makes my plates sparkle and it washes very well. So create awareness about what that product does. It shouldn't be only about, oh, this brand is we have the Tushar brand, okay, and we have our dishwashing liquid. Let us also know what that dishwashing liquid does, and people should be exposed to what your business does, the tone of your voice, and the range of your product and your services. That is, if you have, okay, you created awareness about this, your brand, the Tushar brand, then if you have other products or services, let people to also know about it during the course of your campaign. If your campaign is successful, the next time a person comes in contact with your brand, they won't just know who your brand is. They will also know what your brand does, how your product is being effective, or the services you render, how good it is. So there is the need to when you embark on brand awareness campaign, there is the need to show your target audience more about what your product entails, what it does, the good thing about your product. So a very good example of this is this Tushar dishwashing liquid with the campaign name No Be Wash. They want to create awareness about their product, the dishwashing liquid, how good it is when you use it to wash your plates, how your plate sparkles. So they embarked on this awareness campaign called No Be Wash. So the next one we'll be looking at is the social media campaign. Social media campaigns are those campaigns that comes up on basically any social media platforms like the Facebook, Instagram, the TikTok, Twitter, LinkedIn, or Snapchat. So when you already know that, okay, my target audience they make use of this Instagram when you know that your target audience make use of Instagram, then you decide to do a campaign to get across to your target audience, that's fine. You can also use Facebook, as long as you know that, okay, when I do this campaign, my target audience are going to be able to resonate with it, and jump on the campaign. So there is a need for you, when you are doing social media campaigns, there's a need for you to select the right medium you're going to use for your target audience. So social media campaigns, marketing campaigns can be used for a whole range of different goals. So when you are having a social media campaign, there is usually a goal. Every campaign you are going to put out there usually comes with a goal. So if your social media campaign goals can be to create more brand awareness, to retarget your visitors who have bounced out of your website, or to even increase the followers on your page, or to even push more customers to buy products that you are selling. So a very good example of this social media campaign was the one we did for our brand, for our client, Always Me, which says, show them that they are always loved. The theme of this campaign was always loved. Like I said, every campaign will always have a theme. So this theme here was always loved. And the theme of this campaign was for the Always Me lovers to post a picture of a baby they love and tag it Always Love. This process, they were creating awareness about their brand, and people got to know the product and services they rendered, and the products they sell, and they got to know more about their brand. So let's move on. The next one we'll be looking at is the email marketing campaign. Email marketing campaigns consist of a coordinated set of individual email messages that are deployed across a specific period of time with one specific purpose, which can be to download or to sign up for a webinar or make a purchase. So email marketing campaigns actually happens when you as a brand, you need to get in contact with your customers to buy the new product on your website, or maybe to just notify them about the new designs you have, or to make them purchase some of the stock you have in your website. So launching an email marketing campaign is give your company the chance to talk to its customers one-on-one. When you do email marketing campaign, you are directly talking to your customers. It is one-on-one conversation. So then when they see, there is usually a call to action in the email marketing campaign, which can be to sign up. Maybe you are doing this campaign for a webinar you have, then you can just say the CTA there, that is the call to action there, will be to sign up for the email for the webinar, and it can also be maybe buy now or shop now. So you want them to buy what you have in store or the new products you have in store. Then you can use the CTA of buy now. A very good example of this was this one also by Always Me, which is show your little ones that they are always loved. This one was during the Valentine period, and the theme there was always loved also. So they had these created boxes for their at different prices, ranging from 15K, 30K, 50K, and 80K. So they wanted their customers to buy these Valentine boxes for their loved ones. So they came up with an email marketing campaign to create awareness about this and to urge their customers to buy this stuff they have in stock. As you can see, the CTA there was visit our website. The website there was linked to, and it says visit our website to start shopping from our Valentine shop and get a gift. So we wanted them to buy stuff from their website. So they kept the link there for their customers to be able to buy what they have in stock. So if you're thinking that email marketing might not work, it is stale, I don't think people read emails, and I don't think it's right to do email marketing. But let me tell you this, there are over 4 billion daily email users, and this number is expected to climb up to 4.6 billion by 2025, as recorded by Statista 2021. So the next one we'll be looking at is sales promotion campaigns. Sales promotion campaigns focus on marketing tactics aimed at increasing brand recognition and stimulating demand for certain items. So sales promotion campaigns can be maybe when your brand decides to do sales on product. Let's say you have some stock, some product that has been in your store for a while, then you just want to get rid of then bring in new items. You can decide to do a sales promotion campaign. Then you say, then you can call it any name, maybe I will for you, just give it a theme. Then you can even decide to promote it. The aim of this sales campaign, they are usually to create audiences, attract new leads, and to keep existing customers interested. Take for instance, I've been your customer since from the day I, for a while, and all of a sudden you decide to do a sales promotion campaign. Definitely, I'll be interested in it. Oh, this brand is doing sales. Oh, let me jump on it. Let me buy what they are selling. Ah, this stuff that used to be so priced before 50K. Oh, now they are doing it at the lower price. Okay, this is nice. Let me buy this. So it keeps your existing customer interested, and it can attract new leads. How? When I think people really like sales, when we as humans see a brand doing sales, and if you want to jump into it, this thing that I saw on a particular, maybe their competitor was not even doing sales at that period of time, then you saw that this stuff I want to buy, these people are doing sales on it, definitely I want to buy from them. I will ignore their competitor that is not doing sales. So it attracts new leads when you do sales promotion campaign. So also, sales promotion campaign can have objectives like to create brand awareness, increase revenue. So when you do sales promotion campaign, it's like create awareness about your brand. People get to know about your brand. People that have not seen this brand before, or maybe all of a sudden while they were strolling or on Instagram page, then your page pops up to see that, oh, you guys are having a sales, let me come to this, let me buy what you are selling. So awareness, people that don't even know about your brand, they get to see what you are selling, then it can increase revenue, people get to buy what you are having and induce existing customers to buy more. A sample to this is this one by Always Me also. It's the Black Friday sales, up to 30% discount off on their selected product. If people see this, there's always interest. People want to buy. People like sales. So when people saw this, this sales by Always Me, they were interested. They wanted to know more. And I'm sure they visited the website and to get more details about the products they sell, and they were able to purchase some for their loved ones. So the next one we'll be looking at is advertising campaign. Advertising campaign is a set of ads targeted at particular audience segments with the aim of increasing conversion. The aim of advertising campaign is to increase conversion. So advertising campaign is usually like a series. Let me put it that way. You have season one tagged Women Are Good. For instance, the season one is tagged Women Are Good. Then inside that season one that is tagged Women Are Good, then we have episode one, Why Women Are Good, Why You Should Watch This. So that's how advertising campaign usually looks. So it's a set of ads targeted at a particular audience. A very good example to explain what I have said is this Etel Data Is Life campaign. They came up with this campaign with the aim of creating more awareness and getting people about their brands and getting people to jump on their slash data prices. That is which is basically to increase conversion. So they wanted people to know more about that data slash they have and how good it is, why you should jump on it. Then they came up with this advertising campaign. This advertising campaign is tagged Data Is Life, but this one I'm going to play for you is Stew. They also have another one called Condition. They have another one called Love. So they have series. So it's a series, as like I explained earlier on. It's a series that has different names. So let me play this for you all to see.
So make you be my guest, though. Why you the stress? Why you the worry? Are you late, oh yeah? You got everything you need. Are you late?
You can choose to do this with your stew, but not your data. Get more out of life with the new NL data plans. Dial *141# today. Data is life.
Airtel, the smartphone network.
So that was the campaign to create awareness about their data, how data is life, and instead of managing, just we have other options for you. So advertising campaigns are usually similar in nature, with same messages placed across different types of media during a specific period. So the next one we'll be looking at is product launch campaign. As the name implies, product launch. So when a brand intends to launch a product, they can decide to go on a product launch campaign. Product launch campaigns are planned efforts to bring a new product to the market. You have this product, let's take for instance, you want to launch a new phone or a new phone in the market, but people don't know you anywhere. Then you can decide to do a product launch campaign so that you can create awareness about who your brand is and what products, the services you render. Oh, okay, this brand is coming, is a new brand, and you want to, their aim is to tell us about their new phone that they are bringing to the market. Makes sense. So you also try to talk about the properties of that phone, what the phone does, so that you can be able to attract people to buy it. Maybe you come up with a very higher pixel so that, people want to make snap with their phone. So you be, I like the fact that this phone, the megapixel of this phone is higher than everyone I've seen. Oh, I think I should buy this. That's a way of converting people to buy your product. So the goal of a product launch campaign is to make sure that everyone inside your company, your partners, even your target customers know about your new product. You have a new product in town. Your aim is to make sales. How then are you going to do it? So you can decide to go on a product launch campaign so that people will get to know about your product, so that people will be able to purchase what you are selling. Because if you don't create awareness about it, then what's the essence? How then do you make sales? So a very good example to this is this one. You see this Golden Penny. Golden Penny wanted to launch their cereal. So everybody is aware of Golden Mall cereal. So Golden Penny is trying to come to the market with a cereal. How then were they going to create awareness about this product? They decided to embark on a campaign with the team, Find Their Amazing. Instead of the normal way of spelling the amazing, they kept an I there, like amazing. So the aim is just to find out how creative your child is. You make a video of your child doing some creative stuff and you send it to Golden Penny's page just to create awareness about their product, that new product they are launching. So when people see this, there's tendency for people to buy what you are selling. There's tendency for people to love the brand and even want to participate in your campaign. Oh, because of the fact that you are doing that campaign where you said, what's your child's amazing, talk about your child's, the amazing stuff about your child, then people might, I will really love to share amazing stuff about my child, so I think I should jump on this campaign. You get people interacting with your campaign. By so doing, people get to know about your brand. It goes beyond just being on your page alone, being on the press, the your target audience's page, and people are seeing the product, and people, it's creating more awareness about this product that you have, and people get to buy it. So not running product launch campaigns effectively may lead to consumers not being aware of your product, or may potentially create a bad impression of your product. Imagine Golden Penny didn't do any campaign, or they just did it that their product is in town. How then do people get to know about it? They didn't do any campaign. They just kept it within themselves that, okay, we have this new product. We're just going to drop it in one supermarket. How many people would be in that supermarket that decide to drop it? How many people will see that product? Will you be able to reach the target, the goals aim that you've set? So it is very necessary if you as a brand wants to launch a product, it's very necessary to come up with a product launch campaign so that you can create awareness about this product and get people to buy your product. So the next one we'll be looking at is the samples of marketing campaigns. So there are different samples of marketing campaigns, and the first one we'll be looking at is the Always Me by Annie Lee campaign called called Always Loved. So this campaign happened during Valentine period, that was February, and Always Love, they said always me lovers were required to show the little ones in their lives that they are always loved. They came up with a team that would resonate with their target audience. It's very important for your team to resonate with your target audience, because if it doesn't, the probability that your target audience will be able to understand or even jump on your campaign is like, it's not high. So there is a need for your team. Anytime you're coming up with a team for your campaign, there's a need for it to resonate with your target audience. So they said, by joining the Always Love the sticker campaign that took place on their Instagram page, the Always Me lovers were required to upload pictures of the babies they love and wrote a caption about why the baby is always loved and share it on their stories. During that process, awareness was coming about the brand. People got to know about the brand. During that process, people got to know what the brand was offering. There was more insight for people about the brand. So let's move on to the next one. Coca-Cola Share a Coke. So I feel most of us here would have seen this Share a Coke campaign. So the aim of this campaign, Coca-Cola came up with this campaign, Share a Coke, and they replaced their iconic logo with some of the nation's most popular names. Like people, you were seeing your name on their bottles. So there was this urge to buy their products when you saw that your name was written on a bottle. Even me as a person during the period of this Coca-Cola Share Coke campaign, I wanted to buy Coke, because I was, even anytime I wanted to buy Coke, it was, my aim there was to check if my name was on the bottle. So when I see my name or the name of my friend, I buy the Coke just to share it with somebody. So I believe they were able to achieve their goal, which was to share a Coke with somebody, or you buy it for yourself. And they gave their consumers a unique opportunity to connect and share personalized Coke with people who matter the most to them, like their friends, family, loved ones, either in person or virtually. So the next one we'll be looking at is the Peak Milk Share Love, Share Nourishment. So this one came up during the Christmas period. Then Peak Milk consumers were required to simply share love with their friends and family through gifts and acts of kindness, or just by simply being there through tough times. So you buy Peak products, share with your friends, then take a picture, let them know why you are doing this, and capture them, put it on your page and tag the brand. So I believe they were creating awareness about their brand through this process. People got to know about their brand. People got to know what they are saying. Oh, Peak Milk has this one. Oh, Peak Milk has that one. Oh, I love this idea of share love, share nourishment. I think I should do it. I should jump on it. So that's how this one campaign that we have seen so far. Then another one is one by Lacasera, which is this is not a full stop TINAPS. This campaign came up during the Corona period. Lacasera were aware that things were tough for people, and a lot of people left their job. A lot of people were sacked from their job. They didn't know how to go about life. Some people thought that was the final bus stop, but Lacasera came up with this idea. This is not a full stop. This is not the end. There is tomorrow, there is future, there is hope tomorrow. So in that campaign, they told their audience that they should come up with a spoken words and rappers to share their own message. They told their audience, the rappers and the spoken words artists, to share their own messages of hope, inspiration during this tough period of time. So when me as a target audience sees something like this, oh wow, it can encourage me for tomorrow, that maybe I've been thinking during that Corona period, I've been thinking, how will tomorrow be? Is there even hope for me tomorrow? For tomorrow. So this time around, if I now see this campaign going on by Lacasera, and I've seen what other artists have been doing, the message of hope has really given me hope. I myself, if I'm good with spoken words, I can also jump on the campaign and encourage people, give people messages of hope, inspiration, and with that process, people get to know, oh, Nakasira is, you even see people having conversations around that, well, Nakasira is doing something, you know, listen to, some people might just be there to listen to the message of hope. Some might be there to, okay, because of the message of hope that Nakasira is doing, I think I should even buy their products. So this is another example of marketing campaign. So next thing we'll be looking at is steps to designing a marketing campaign. There are various, these steps to designing marketing campaigns are, you need to set a goal. It's very necessary to set a goal. Your campaign should have an aim, purpose for doing it. Then you need to define your target audience. Who are your target audience? Clearly define them. Then choose your channel. What channel do you intend to use to pass across this campaign, this message you have to your target audience? Set a campaign timeline. Your campaign should have a timeline. When is it going to start and when is it going to finish? You don't just wake up one morning and say, I'm starting this campaign today, and in the next 30 minutes you think it will end, or you get people to jump on your campaign. It doesn't work like that. There's a strategy, there's a process. So you need to set your timeline. And you need to set your budget and develop a campaign team. Very important, develop a team. Those teams sync to your target audience. They tend to resonate with it. So let's have a clearer look at all these listed stuff. The first one, set a clear goals. And when setting your goal can be to create awareness about the brand, to improve engagement on your page, or to increase website traffic. So setting specific goals and metrics or key performance indicators that will help you determine how your campaign is performing against the goal is key, as this helps define expected outcome of your campaign. So when you set a goal, it helps you know how far you are going in your campaign. If your number one goal, as it is here, is to increase website, then you now draw out a strategy. So if we say we are going to increase our website traffic, so what are we going to do? How are we going to do this? So it is very important to set goals that are smart. When I say smart, I mean specific. The S there is specific, like it is clear, straight, and your goals are measurable. Measurable in the sense that you said your first goal was specific, which is to increase website traffic. Then is it measurable? Like, how are you going to know that you have increased your website traffic? If there is nothing for you to put in place that, okay, this is what we are going to use to know that we have increased website traffic, I think we should change that goal again. Make sure that goal is specific, is measurable. Then if it is specific and measurable, you can move on. Just check again, check your goal. Is it attainable? This thing that I said I'm going to do, is it achievable? Is it attainable? If it is not attainable or achievable, then you can go back again and make sure that this goal you are going to set for this campaign, it is specific, measurable, and achievable. Then you move on. Is it relevant? We said we are going to create awareness. Okay, we know how we are going to measure the awareness on our page, and we know how we are going to achieve this. But now, is it relevant? If for this campaign, is it necessary? Look at it from that aspect again. This goal that you said you are going to do, is it necessary for the campaign? And make sure your goal is time bound. Very important, time bound. The next thing we are going to look at is define your target audience. It is very necessary for you to define who your target audiences are. Who are they? Have a clear definition of the people you want to meet, or the people that your product are going to, or the people that you intend to buy what you are selling, what you have in store. So your target audience refers to the specific group of consumers most likely to want your product or services, those people that are interested in what you want, and therefore the group of people who should see and engage with your campaign. If this campaign that you are doing doesn't resonate with your target audience, or your target audience cannot relate with it, sorry, they are not going to jump on your campaign. They are not going to do whatever you ask them to do. So it is very important to define your target audience and look at what your target audience wants. When you can determine that, oh, my target audience are this type of people that, oh, they like campaigns like spoken word, they are great actors, they'll be good with doing some TikTok stuff. Okay, yes, I think this idea would be great. So there's a need for you to clearly define your target audience. And target audience may be defined by age, agenda, income, location, interest, or other factors. Then you need to choose your channels. You can't just say, this campaign, let's run it on LinkedIn. How sure are you that if you run this campaign on LinkedIn, your target audience are even there and are going to jump on your campaign or do what you expect them to do during the campaign? So there is a need for you to choose your channels. Determine the channel that is best for this campaign idea that you have. You might have all your target audience on every social media, cool. But which one, this campaign that you are doing, which one will bring more sales? Which one will bring, if your goal is to bring have more sales, which one will do the more sales? And if your goal is to create awareness, which one will create awareness for you? Which of the social channels are going to create awareness? So that it is important to choose your channels. So this is usually more effective than broadcasting and achieving only minimal exposure to an audience that is too large. So choose your channels. Very important to choose the channels in which you intend to pass across your message to your target audience. So the next one we'll be looking at is set a campaign. Your campaign should have a timeline, when it is going to start and when it is going to end. You can't just come up with a campaign today now and expect it to be successful. No. Without even going through some process, you just woke up one morning and so without going through the right strategy, you just woke up this morning and said, let's start this campaign. The success of that campaign can't be determined because there is a need for you to set a timeline. And in that timeline, you determine when your campaign is going to start, which it gives you a much better idea on when and how you promote it. Because when you have a clear understanding that this campaign is for 1 month, then you go give it step by step. This week, throughout this week, we are only doing more about our products during this campaign. Okay, so throughout this, the next week, we are going to be promoting the story campaign that we are doing. So basically, when you have a timeline, you'll be able to it will even help in achieving your goals that you have set aside for the campaign. So you have to set a budget. It is very important to set a budget because at the end of the day, if you've said during the campaign strategy document, if you said, okay, we are going to use influencers. So it is important when you are setting the budget, you check, okay, we said we are going to use influencer, we'll put it there. How much is this? Which influencer are you using? If it's Taoma, how much is Taoma going to collect for 16 minutes, for one minute skit? How much is Taoma going to collect? Then you put the price there. Oh, we said we are using Mr. Funny. How much is Mr. Funny going to collect for this? At the end of the day, when you're able to put your budget, then you can realize and say, okay, Mr. Funny's money is too high. And can even come up with the conclusion that we're using 5 influencers. I don't think it's important. Let's reduce it. So your budget will make you, it can even help you in defining your strategy the more. Because at the end of the day, you give it a second thought that these people that we've selected, will they help us achieve our goal? Even if we select 2 out of all these 5 influencers or this social platform that we said we are going to use, won't we still achieve our goals with those 2? So when you set your budget, it will indicate what channels you're able to use and how many people you'll be able to reach. And you should also do research with the minimum spend per channels is before allocating resources across channels. So the next one we'll be looking at is the develop a campaign team, which is very important. Your campaign team, like I said, it resonates with your target audience. So when you have a team, your target audience tends to, it's something that your target audience will never forget. Like, this always love is something you will never forget. It rings during the Valentine period, you always remember. And also, like this Share a Coke, till next 3 years, you always remember this campaign when you hear Share a Coke. So It's something you should always have a team, and your marketing campaign should have an overreaching team that ties everything together. The team is something that ties your entire message together. We, in this always loved one, they wanted to show, they wanted them, their target audience, to show the little ones in their life that they are always loved, that they cherish them. So you have to post a picture of your target audience. So when your team ties everything together, the message you have it to pass across to your target audience. So when you have a team, it passes across that message. So the next one we'll be looking at is executing successful marketing campaigns. The first one is to encourage everyone to join, track and measure results, implement a daily stand-up. So encourage everyone to join, to participate. When you have a campaign, you don't want to do the campaign inside your office in a way that even other people, other team members don't know, or other members in other department don't know about it. It is important for other people in other departments to know about the campaign that is going on in your organization or the campaign you are running for a client, so that people can participate. If the people in your office are those that resonate, that are the target audience of your customer, so it's of your client, it is important for you to let them know about this. Like this always love, we told everyone that, oh, we are doing this campaign, we always love, you guys can join. Our team members, some of them have the relatives, their nieces or their cousins, so they could join, they could participate in this campaign. So when people see that, people are on the campaign, it can attract more people to join the campaign. So there is need to make sure everybody in your organization are aware of this campaign and they can participate in the campaign. Track and measure results. Track and measure results is important because you have to know the success of everything you've been doing. You said you are going to do this, do that. So at the end of the day, there's a need for you to check, okay, I said I'm going to increase website traffic for my brand. How far have we gone? Okay, at the end of the day, during the 1 month of the campaign, we're able to have maybe 800 more people to visit our website compared to last month. So that's how you track and measure your results, to know how successful your campaign is. A good example of this one is the mail they sent. They wanted to know how many people opened it, because it's important. You need to know how many people opened it, how many people clicked on the link you kept there, and how many people that visited your website. So by this, if you see the number of people, you'll be okay, the campaign is okay, it's doing well, people are visiting the website, people open the email, people read what we have, people are aware of what we are selling that we kept in the email. So the next thing we'll be looking at is implement a daily stand-up meeting. So in this implement a daily stand-up meeting, it's just you coming up to check how far the progress has been. So let's say the campaign started today, which is for a month, it started today. And after today, we can now come back. Okay, so today we did this, we did that. How far did we go? Oh, we were able to have 10 people join the campaign. Okay, let's hope for more people to join the campaign tomorrow. So there is the need for a daily stand-up meeting to check how far the progress on the campaign has been and to see if there is anything in the strategy that should be adjusted. Because when you see when there's a daily meetup, so if you see that, oh, we said we are going to be posting pictures regularly, and at the end of the day, the pictures we are posting regularly is causing confusion. So there's a need for you to, during the meeting, daily meeting, you cannot say, okay, then let's readjust this that we said in the strategy campaign. Let's change it. Let's do it another thing. And yeah, we've come to the end. Thank you very much. If you have questions, you can unmute yourself to ask.
Well done, Boluwatife
So I have a question for you.
Thank you very much, Agnes.
What happens if there is no team, like a general team, to put all of this together? If it's just one person, is this something one person can do, or there's a need for a team, or maybe outsource it to an agency?
Coming up with a team is not necessarily it's not necessary for you to outsource it to an agency. If you have a brand, your personal brand, you want to come up with a team. No, it's something you can do by yourself. And the team there, it's important for you to have a team because it's something that your target audience can remember you for. So if your target audience remembers you for a team, it's okay than you doing a campaign that they cannot even relate. There's nothing to pinpoint about the campaign, and there's nothing they can even use to remember the campaign for, or to even say, let me join the campaign. Like, if I'm to remember this campaign, maybe because there is this, the Always Love, the team they put there is something that I resonate with, it's something that is touching, it's something that I love. So I can always remember and decide to use. So I feel it is important for your campaign to always have a team. I hope I was able to answer your question, Agnes.
Yes, thank you. Thank you.
All right, thank you very much for the session, Boluwatife. Okay, to start with, I just want to know if it's possible to, and that's the first question, if it's possible to get the slide, probably to our email addresses. That's number one. Number two would be, for a campaign, I love the fact that you were able to run us through pre-campaign, during the campaign, and then post-campaign. But my question would be, what's the place of being flexible in a campaign in such a way that you've planned how the campaign is going to run already, but while you're executing, you noticed probably there's a change in the demand of the target audience. And let's say the campaign is going to run for a year or 6 months. You notice there's a trend you want to jump on that would still have an advantage to your brand. What's the place of flexibility when it comes to your campaign plan?
So if you notice that there is something changing and you feel that if you do this right now, your target audience will not be able to jump on your campaign, or your campaign will be dead. Nobody will even look at your campaign side. You can always have a backup plan. You can always change the strategy there. That's one good thing about digital campaign or digital strategy. You can always change your strategy when you notice that, oh, this is where I'm going. No, if we start this campaign now, or we've even started the campaign, these people will not do this. What do we not do what we expect them to do? Okay, let's have a change. We can come back again with your team, sit together and re-strategize, think of a better way, think of a better thing to do that will make people to jump on your campaign. I hope I was able to answer your question, please.
Yes, I got it. Thank you very much, Boluwatife. So the first question was if we can get this particular slide just for to make reference and glean from what you shared already.
Okay, no, the slide is not shareable. Sorry about that.
Okay, but can we, is there a way we can, because I saw on your website that we can, the past launch and learn sessions we uploaded, is that going to be the case for now?
Yes, we will share the video. The information about the video would be up on our social medias in a few days, and you can check us on our YouTube
channel. All right.
It's uploaded there, so you can watch and share the video. In the absence of any question, thank you so much for joining us today. We are so excited that you're here. Like I said, the video will be available on YouTube. And if you're watching this on YouTube, can you drop your questions also in the comment section? We would address them as soon as we see them. Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you for joining in. Have a wonderful day.